when we first started, we always had, we were future thinking in the fact that we wanted to do this, we wanted to tour here, we wanted to go there, we wanted our albums to be successful here and there and ever, you know, and we worked really hard at it. But in a strange way, now we have achieved that in a lot of countries in the world. It does take away some of the incentive.
It seems like a long time since we began, yeah. It seems unimaginable what's happened. And I think we always had big egos. I don't know if that's the right word. We always believed that we had something special and that we could do anything that anyone else did. This kind of thing, you know, that's the kind of belief that kept us going in the early days. But I don't think we quite believed what would happen. I don't think we even knew what was possible.
We don't want to become old, rich, and useless.
Fuck today, it's tomorrow. I don't know why, and if you ask any of the other members, I don't know why we're together.
We think that in spite of all problems that we may have, that Queen is still something just kind of precious, because you can't make a group which works. It happens, and if you're very lucky, it probably doesn't happen more than once in your life.
We've basically achieved what we wanted to do, I think, and we want to keep on doing it for a little while, you know, and not just give up.
I think we all find it quite difficult now to actually sort of to do nothing, to laze around and do nothing. I don't think we all get very bored and get fidgety and want to do something, work, which is good, I suppose, in a way.
In a way, it becomes harder because now it's like staying power, you know, like you have to sort of... Because I was thinking, you know, somebody else asked me that the other day, Selena Scott, and like the question is like, you've achieved everything, what else is there?
I don't know, perhaps more of the same.
I know there'll be a time where I can't run around on stage because it'll be ridiculous, you know, and I know when there comes a time when you have to stop. But music will still be my thing. All we hear is Radio Gaga, Radio Goo Goo, Radio Gaga. All we hear is Radio Gaga, Radio Goo Goo, Radio Gaga.
I'm going probably through a very uncertain phase in my life at the moment. As part of the insecurities of being involved in the music business or in a band. All we hear is
Radio Gaga. If I could give them any advice, it would be don't break up. There's no need to break up. Just have a long holiday, but don't break up. Radio Goo-Goo,
Radio Gaga. The thing which holds us finally together is the fact that Queen is a lot better than any one of us.
Yes.
This chemistry that's worked has really worked for us, and so why, you know, why kill the goose that laid the golden egg? All we hear is Radio Gaga, Radio Gaga.
I've been there as long as the Stones and the Who and bands like that. So the legend, those legends were sort of built in the 60s. They came in the second echelon, and maybe their legendary status hasn't been reached yet. But I'm sure when the great rock and roll book is written at the turn of the century, they will be up there with the legends.